We are on day five of the eruption of Mauna Loa. So where is the lava now and how close is it to Saddle Road? Joining us this morning with an update is Lis Gallant, geologist at the Hawaiian Volcano Observatory. Good morning, Lis. Thanks for joining us once again.
Good morning. Thanks for having me back.
Now, at last check, the lava flow slowed down to a pace of 0.02 miles per hour. So what's the latest?
We're still seeing very slow advance rates from both Fissure 3 and Fissure 4. Those are our two active fissures. They're both moving at about half a football field an hour, so still slowly moving along, but not the 1 mile per hour that we saw at the onset of the eruption.
So when could it reach Saddle Road right now? Still at least a week?
Yeah, we're still looking at that timeline, but it might be variable due to the lava or inundating the flatter areas. And so it can spread when it hits the nooks and crannies that are on the flat part of the saddle. And so that's a variable estimate.
And when you say spread, what do you mean by spread?
So if you're looking at any images or videos of the lava flow, there are these really narrow channels when it's moving down the steeper slopes. And then when it hits a flat spot, it kind of spreads out laterally. And so now instead of having kind of one main channel, there's two small little fingers coming off at the base of this flow. And so it's accommodating some of that lava in the wider direction as well as in the longer direction.
So maybe creating more fingers.
Exactly.
Okay. But nothing new overnight in terms of new fissures.
No new fissures. No, excuse me. No weird signals. So it's pretty status quo right now for us.
Now, there have been tremors, though, detected in the location of the currently active fissures. Can you tell us what that indicates?
Absolutely. So tremor is a signal that just tells us that there's fluids moving through cracks and into the rift. And so that's just the signal of the magma that's moving into the rift and erupting in those areas. And so as long as we see those tremors, we are going to have eruptive activity. And so the fact that they are in that area means that we're probably going to stay in that area of eruption for the time being. And we aren't expecting to see any downward propagation until the signal tells us otherwise.
Now, Lis, what does your monitoring entail? Is someone out there constantly, or is the lava flow being measured and assessed at certain times of the day?
So we have, it's an all hands on deck situation. We have flight crews that are out there every morning, and so they're monitoring it until the weather gets bad and we have to pull them off. We have our seismologists and our geophysicists constantly watching the signals. And so it's a combination of people watching in the field, in the lab from webcams, and also looking at our monitoring data as it's coming in real time.
And then finally, Lis, anything else that you and your peers will be watching for as we head into the weekend?
We're just going to keep tracking it, and we have colleagues in the lab who are doing some of the chemical analyses, and they've given us some awesome information that we're not looking at recycled magma from 1982. We're looking at totally new magma, and so we're going to just be watching and giving everybody updates as best we can.
Well, Lis Gallant with the Hawaiian Volcano Observatory, we appreciate your time and your live update.
Thank you so much for having me.